Hi everyone, welcome back to the Semaphore channel. My name is Tommy. If you're new here, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you don't miss any future content. If you are a React developer, you are probably very familiar with the Create React app. This is the official way of bootstrapping a new React project. You run this command, and after a few moments, you get a working project, something you can start working on. But Create React App has a few problems. First, it's slow and it's bloated. It installs a lot of unnecessary packages, and depending on your network speed, it can take up to 50 minutes to initialize. Second, it's outdated. It doesn't receive the attention or the updates it deserves. So there's a chance of introducing vulnerabilities. And third, there's no compatibility with newer plugins, so it's not well integrated into the React ecosystem. For example, for a time this tool was incompatible with the last version of Tailwind CSS, so it can be troublesome to initialize new projects. All this make a poor choice this tool a poor choice for creating a new React project. But for every problem, there is a solution. This time we can thank Evan Yu, who is the creator of Vue, a front-end framework. He delivered us a new alternative to Create React App called Vite. So Vite is a tool that combines project bootstrapping. It takes also a development server. It combines a bundler, and it has a lot of niceties to make development faster and leaner. It was initially created for Vue, but it has evolved past Vue and can take other frameworks like React, Svelte, Solid, Quick, or Preact. So it's a very versatile tool. Let's talk a bit about Vite benefits and its features. First, we have native ESM. ESM is a standard for loading JavaScript as modules in browsers. Before this standard was available, developers had to bundle the code before using it, so they had to concatenate everything, every JavaScript into one file and send it to the server. This is how Create React App worked, and it leads to a slow development experience. It's awkward because every change needs a bundling step and sending the whole package to the client, to the browser. Vite uses ESM to eliminate this need for bundling, so there's no bundling with Vite during development. This leads to a better experience. It's faster, it's more intelligent, and it loads only the files it needs on demand, only the files that are updated. And this capacity of using native ESM is really a game changing from the perspective of a developer. Number two, ES Build. While ESM is very useful, it does not work in all cases, such as in bare modules, like modules we import from npm. So something like this will fail on the browser. Vite will detect this situation and will fix it in two ways. It will use ES Build to pre-bundle the code, and second, it will rewrite the URL so it's valid and the browser can load it correctly. So this also applies to static assets. With Vite, we can do something like this, which normally would not work, but in this case it will work because Vite will do all the rewriting and the pre-bundling and make it work in the frontend, so this makes things more intuitive. The side effect of this is that dependencies are strongly cached, so every file and static asset, every source file is cached via HTTP headers, and that makes reloading faster. And because Vite uses ES Build, and ES Build is so much faster than other builders and bundlers like Webpack or Parcel, the whole experience is more snappier. So the third benefit is hot module replacement. This is a feature that allows us to make changes in the application without losing the state. So we can make a change in a file, this file is pushed to the browser, but the state is not lost. So in other tools, in other setups, we would need to reload the page and click our way through the state before we were before the change. With Vite, this is not needed because it kept the state we were before making a change. So this makes things easier and quick, and Vite can invalidate all the files that are depending on our changes. What do I mean with this? That if we make a change in a file, it's not this file that's updated and sent to the browser, but it also can check which files are depending on my change and also push all those dependencies to the browser. This makes things more intuitive, faster, and automatic. And in combination with ESM, this works in parallel, so it's a very fast experience and it's a very comfortable workflow. So the four benefits called CSS splitting. Vite can identify which CSS code is needed for the page we are seeing, and instead of serving the whole CSS, it only serves the parts or the chunks that are needed for the render. The files are loaded in a async way, in async chunks, when a component is invoked, so we don't spend time waiting for unnecessary CSS to be loaded. This makes the application faster and the whole development, you know, more organic. The fifth feature is a very rich feature set and support. Vite offers, for example, out of the box support for TypeScript. It can read TS files and it can take full advantage of the typing system without additional configurations. It can transpile. It doesn't use the traditional TSC transpiler that we are used to. It uses a different system, which is ESBuild, and it's very much an improvement over TSC. It's about 20 or 30 times faster. And when we combine this with hot module replacement, we can expect updates in TypeScript code to be seen on the browser in under 50 milliseconds, which is really, really fast. So Vite also supports GSX. It can natively handle GSX and TSX files without plugins, without extra configurations. Vite uses ESBuild for transpiling GSX files, and this makes transpiling very, very fast. In the realm of styling, Vite is highly versatile. It supports vanilla CSS and preprocessors like SCSS, SAS, Less Stylus, or Post CSS, which means that whatever system you like to style is supported by Vite. And on the data front, Vite allows to load JSON files directly into the project, making it easier to work with static datasets. It also supports tree shaking, so you don't need to load the whole JSON file, only the parts you need. And it supports dynamic imports with variables, so it gives you more control over code splitting, and it allows you to lazy load files, making the performance of applications a lot better. Final thing I want to talk about Vite, it's its bundler. For development, there's no bundling, it's just ESM files sent over the network, but for a production, for deployment, we do want a bundler, and Vite uses Rollup by default, which is faster and more advanced than other bundlers like Webpack. It's well-known, it's mature, it offers features like code splitting and tree shaking and dynamic imports. And it has a lot of optimization techniques to create a smaller bundler. It can reduce the number of files you need to load compared to other bundlers, and it has a very broad range of plugins. You know, you have an ecosystem of plugins to enhance your bundling experience, to do more things. So it's a very good bundler that's only used for production. So in conclusion, if you are looking to escape the bloat, the sluggishness that comes with Create React App, Vite is an excellent choice that's worth trying. Why stick with the old when there's something new? It's free. It's better almost in every way. So give it a try. If you're a React developer, if you are a front-end developer, test it out and see how it works for you. And if your project is already using Create React App, if you already started with Create React App, not all slots, you can migrate into Vite. So I will leave a link in the description on how to do that. And I hope this video gave you some value. I hope you enjoyed watching it. We're committed to making good content here on YouTube. So if you liked it, I will ask you to like and subscribe, which helps us a lot and keeps us motivated to keep making good content. So thank you for watching and see you in the next one.